and even the level of our the dimension of our faith. So in the Philippines, there are so many catechetical centers that form catechists for the basic ministry of teaching, of doing catechesis, systematic instruction. But and then there are several centers that cater to form the catechists at the university level, the masteral, the doctoral, in the area of religious education. But the portion that is in between the basic catechetics or religious education and the masteral university level, that area is really gray. And yet, that is what is most needed, because that is supposed to be the area of coordinators, of leaders that will accompany the catechists who are neophytes or who are in the ministry. That's why the Salian Catechetical Center that has also transformed from the bankrupt of so many years has ventured into, okay, let's lift the area of the basic catechetical training, because there are so many of them there. And they already have the masteral, so let's venture into this as our response to this challenge that the Church of the Philippines is facing. And here you are, the first batch. So we thank you for responding to the invitation, and I suppose by the looks of your faces, you're happy.
Yes.
Important to say happy, eh? Huh?
Yes.
Happy para kahit anong pag-aapi, happy pa rin.
Amen.
Si Sister Nora, na nakakaalala ng kanilang magandang alaala. Okay. Just to what you call this, give you the, I believe that Dr. Alessandro already gave you the orientation, but it's better that from time to time we go back to that orientation. Kasi mahalaga, as I always say to the catechist, no, it's very important to be in touch with one's story. Even in our own formation, there is a story behind it. And when we were doing this program, we tried to come out, we tried to draw out a story that should really include or cover the experiences and the content and the methodology of this course. And so the story behind this program is based on the basic paradigm that the General Directory suggests to all those involved in the formation of catechists. No? And that is the framework of being, doing, and knowing. So in any formation of catechists, the program, the curriculum should include these three basic dimensions of being. So being, knowing, and doing, or savoir-faire, doing well, doing the right way. If you notice in your program, This is the different topics for these 2 weeks have been organized. No, so we purposely chose the overall process, which is the appreciative inquiry, and Dr. Nati led you on. Ano pala si Dr. Kami na pakita na may misa. Pag natapos na ako ng mga homily, kita nakita na ako na. Naisahan ako nito, dapat ito yung tumayo nito sa harapan eh. Anyway, the doctor had the good morning. So I hope, I believe that she led you to this process of appreciative inquiry, appreciating or acknowledging, you know, the goodness that you have experienced in the years of your doing ministry. And then, through this appreciative inquiry, In these 2 weeks, no, you are invited to continue to dream, to continue to envision, because this is what makes our catechetical ministry, our involvement in the ministry, alive and life-giving. If you continue dreaming, in spite of maybe challenges, difficulties that we know, we all encounter in the field, in the catechetical field. And, but our dreams and our experiences should be read against principles that are beyond us, so that there is a balance of subjectivity and objectivity. And this is the third part of the appreciative inquiry, which is the design. That we co-construct, you know, with these principles, our experiences, our own, I would say, story of being catechists or being catechetical leaders, and our dream for our local church, for our catechists. So all these courses are part of this design. So then that is a phase 3 ng AI. Hanggang sa next week, we're at the end, after going through all the courses, then you're asked, then what? After these 2 weeks, what am I to do as a catechetical leader, as a one who's involved in managing the catechetical ministry? So medyo, kaya itong AI na ito is both theoretical and practical. Okay? So yan yung overall. Then so in the design, so we follow the being, the knowing, and the doing. So Monsignor Pierre started with presenting the vision of the church, upon which is grounded our own vision for catechesis. And then, yes, the other day, Dr. Nati and Bishop Abilio brought you into the basic source of catechesis, which is the Word of God. And now, today, we'll enter into the third dimension, which is being. That's why, which we go beyond the psychological aspect of this being, since we are already at the second level, and we focus on the spirituality aspect of this being. So our topic today is the spirituality of a catechetical leader in this context of the new evangelization. So this will be our discussion for today. It will be a light discussion, since tapos pagod na kayo sa apat na sa tatlong araw na I'm sure Mr. Si Jerry, Dr. Nati, and Bishop Abilio that gave you a lot of inputs that mahirap na kumbaga ang ane. So relax na muna tayo, because we'll be talking about ourselves, no? We'll be looking into ourselves, but in the context of the spirituality. And then connect again, and I will spend some time to share my own understanding of the new evangelization, which for some of you might have heard me already. Sorry na lang po, maybe it's just for you to review. And then the afternoon, we're going to have a workshop on the theme itself, which is the spirituality of the catechetical leaders. So I hope that the discussion will also be interactive. Nasana. Okay. Anyway, since I am going to prepare first the LCD, so while I am preparing the mahirap sa mga technology. I just give you a kind of a discussion. Wala tayong expectation. Maraming tayong expectations. Okay. First of all, please get a diet ba. Magda-diet sharing tayo. Sister, yeah, the partner. Please first, try to determine between the two of you who is A and who is B.